The Last Day. God, just the way it pops up is menacing as shit. So Beat is still here. Beat's still here. Encouraging so far. Hey. Scramble again. We lost another day, man. So it's day 7. And you're still here. Dude, your hands!
What?
Oh. Oh no, we have like a fucking time limit of like a couple minutes. Nah, man, I'm gonna hold myself together. Again, it feels like cheating if the composer can just click her fingers. Oh, not composer. If the game master can click her fingers and just go, yep, day's done. We got nowhere. Like, we did so little. And she's just like, yep, no, day's done. You did a boss fight. Day's done. Can't fade away now. Rhyme needs me. I ain't going up and smoke till I save her. You're Neku. I don't know how much time. I don't got much time. I know. Let's hurry over there. Today we put an end to all this. And we're at the point where it is every single person. Every single person is now frozen over. Every single one of them. Concerning. Concerning. Damn, it's amazing how fast the days go by when you don't spend forever grinding each day. Like, every day individually took like an hour and a half to 2 hours before. I just did the last 2 days in an hour and a half. Damn, maybe the game's nowhere near as long as I've made it out to be, and I just spent way too much time grinding because I wanted to eat food. It's literally everyone. It's literally everyone at this point. It is. Is it the shopkeepers too? Is it the shopkeepers too?
Welcome to Sunshine. Thanks.
If you work, you're fine. I mean, it makes sense because, like, they can see us when we go in there. Like, they did say before the shops have the thing on the wall that lets us walk in there and be visible. When we walk in there, so it makes sense if the shopkeepers are also safe. It's literally everyone. There's literally not a single person left walking around. Quite literally. Fucking everyone. If I go into this... Yeah, I can't, like, read the bullets or anything. So many paranoid saves are happening right now. Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. It's fine. Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. It's fine. It's fine. We'll be totally fine. I'm gonna do this level 1. You fucking watch. Oh, there's a Reaper. Of course. Yo. To right the countless wrongs of our day, we shine this light of true redemption. This place may become as paradise. What a wonderful world such would be. No response. Not even gonna fight us. Alright. Shibuya River, here we go. Oh fuck, I guess Minami is pretty fucking powerful right now then. Oh fuck, is Minami actually this fucking strong? Oh god. No way, man. You said that guy made it to booty call? It's the stupidest line in this game so far, and I love it. Stupidest line in the entire game so far. Then he knows the composer's here. This is bad, yo. He's gonna beat us there. Get it? Beat. Calm down. First, we have to find the GM. If we don't save Rhyme. I know. Iron Face. We gotta find Iron Face. Not much of a river. Still, Joshua was bent on coming here. To see the composer? To see Mr. H? Let's pick up the pace. Yeah. Oh, fuck. I will never stop saving. Until the time is up, I'll never stop saving the game. I didn't even get that fucking the right amount of syllables in the line. Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ. J- Just kill all of my aspirations on wanting to be any form of musician. Did that say Trail of the Sinner? Did that say Trail of the fucking Sinner? Have we entered a fucking Dark Souls area? What the fuck? What? Mail now? Konishi wields Shadow and Illusion. You'll find only lies with the naked eye. During battle, she always hides in the white darkness. Begin by casting Taboo Noise into the Heart of Chaos. Excuse me, what? Then, once you find where she truly lurks, your real battle will begin. P.S. Beware of shadows. What a weird mail. Did Iron Face send it? What, to say he's there to beat me? Right, who then? I don't know. Better keep moving, man. Yeah. Cast Taboo Noise. That's concerning. Also, peeps. Definitely noticing the heaps that are here. Rubicon! Because we're crossing the Rubicon now. Hi, Minami. Should I just already put myself up above level... I should just do that, shouldn't I? 20 is what I did for the lolly people. I will do 20 for now. Save again. And save again. I'm scared! If I lose, I have to do the bitch thing and level myself up to halfway of what my max level is. Hi, buddy.
So Zeta slow.
Zeta slow.
What?
Wah. You. No. What the factor took you so long? It's Tabooty. Are we just calling him Tabooty now? Is that just his name? His name is just now Tabooty? Okay. We don't have time for this. Move, you ain't what matters. Foil! First, outer, inner, last. And then, and this is the last stop. Not even I can break the barrier ahead. Her iron frostiness put it up. She's here? Damn it, I knew it. It was just like her, yo. Hiding like a coward just out of reach. Stupid Hector Pascals, she's not through here. Huh? Then where, yo? You Zeta morons, you haven't noticed? She's been with you. The whole time.
Huh?
She's literally our shadow. She's literally our shadow! You a lessy motherfucker! Behind you! You was hiding in my shadow? I didn't expect to have to reveal myself like this. By my forecast, you two should have been erased yesterday. Speaking of anomalies, Mr. Minami Moto. Heh. I'm only here because your barrier's blocking me out. Unforeseen circumstances aside, my plans are proceeding without a hitch. You said you would be fucking erased yesterday. That seems like at least a tiny little bit of a hitch. You've yielded far more data than I ever projected. Shut it, Iron Face. And give me back Rhyme.
What?
Huh? Why are you going what I say? Like I said, you've yielded so much data. See the power of foresight? Hey, who gives a digit? This dude's using maths to swear. I appreciate it. Hurry up and open this barrier. Open up this fucking gate! Before I turn you into Shibuya River sludge. Alright, I'll remove the barrier under one condition. Yeah, what are you scheming this time? When you become composer, I want you to make me your conductor. Otherwise, the barrier stays. Excuse me, what? You're double-crossing Megs? Analysis shows that Shibuya is headed toward an untimely end. If revolution is upon us, then who has the highest probability of surviving the ensuing chaos? A free spirit. You. Please excuse my dear Aunt Sally. PEMDAS. PEMDAS. Since when I was in school, it was we did it in the order PEDMAS. But I guess PEMDAS does also make sense. Like, it's literally just swapping around the M and the D. That makes no difference. Azeta, dig your style. You and me think alike. Fear and mercy are garbage. Alright, you got yourself a deal. Then I'll take care of the barrier. I feel like we are very inconsequential right now to what's actually happening. Attention, binomials of the UG. Introducing your new composer. His name is me. Where do you think you're going? I'm afraid I can't let you take one step further. You'd betray the composer? Betray? I simply choose to align with the man in charge. It hardly matters who. What? As far as I'm concerned, anyone could be the composer. Suppose Minami Moto fails. But by then, Kitaniji will have sustained serious injuries in the process of protecting the composer. At which point, I could finish him in a heartbeat. So everybody's just a pawn to you? No matter how this ends, I'll be conductor. Scheming witch. When the composer started requiring opens, I knew the UG revolution had already begun. And what's going on is his fault? I don't presume to know the composer's true intentions, but I intend to outlive this chaos. She chucked the pin. These opens, they're fakes. Wear them and you're finished. I knew it. I have a better pin in my deck. You fucker! You're an asshole. What do you, that's all you think? Please, spare yourself the embarrassment. My analysis are never wrong. Oh, yeah? What's it with the unforeseen circumstances? Sounds like you can't predict Jack, yo. Besides, you're missing something hella crucial. I beg your pardon? Next composer's going to be me, yo. And I ain't never making a punk like you one of my men. So suck on that, yo. Me, work for you? Ha ha ha. You vexatious monkey. You're right, no analysis could ever plumb to the depths of your fatuity. Damn right. Dude, she's making fun of you. Again. What? It's your fault I didn't pick up on Shibuya's changes sooner. You're so busy thinking with your head, you forgot to pay attention with your heart. Enough of your chimp speak. I will obliterate any disruptive elements in my path. Your Neko, I got a pissed at me now. While she comes after me, you snag rhyme. I ain't a Reaper no more, so I can't free rhyme from the pin. But you... Anyway, if I don't make it, take care- Screw you! I'm not bringing rhyme back to life. That's your job. I'll snag a pin if I get the chance, but the rest is you. Alright, man, you said it. Let's do this thing! Oh, here we fucking go. Alright. Kanishi time! I'm scared! I'm scared. Oh, excuse me, what? Excuse me, what? How do we teleport to above the skies of Shibuya? Excuse me, what? Excuse me, what? Excuse me, what? Very hard to focus on attack on getting her while I'm having to pay attention to also the crabs on the bottom screen. Kill the crabs! Ow. I'm digging it. Come on, get her. I am taking a decent amount of damage, but it's not too bad so far. It is very hard. Very hard to kill the things that I don't even know what's going on Neku's screen. I'm fucking, like, getting hit on Neku's screen. I don't even know what's happening. Oh, it's warping. It teleports. It sucks you into the void. Oh, it is constantly being absorbed into the void. Oh, okay. I am terrified that I'm going to have to actually do the entirety of, like, this fight by using, like, fucking... Beat to do damage. Fusion! While I'm finally focusing on Beat, I should probably be trying to do the card stuff, but I have no idea how to do his card stuff in any fucking capacity. Also, she keeps teleporting, and it's very hard to get anything when she when you can't finish a combo because she's teleporting all over the fucking place. Like, I'd love to focus on what on like trying to get stuff with B, but if I can't even get a combo off, then I don't know what the plan is. I don't know what to do here. Bates is also doing basically fucking zero damage. Like, look at how little damage he actually does when he hits. Like, he does basically nothing. Like, even when he hits, it's basically nothing. Like, the amount of damage my partner's been doing has always been supplementary. Oh, she's on the bottom screen now. Oh, now we get a fucking chance. Maybe. Maybe. I actually can't hurt her. Oh, now I can. Oh, when she hides in the... Oh, right. That was a thing, yes. Cast taboo noise at her, and then you can hurt her. We did hear something along those lines. Get her! Get her! Okay, she's back up there. Okay, get up that side. Okay, there she is! Okay. Get her again! Oh my god. Stop using the flame ones. Get her! Oh god. Teleported very quickly onto that one. Get her! Get her! I'm still doing basically zero damage at any fucking given point. Get her! Okay. Get her. Ah! Combo the shit out of her! There she is. Get her! Okay. Cast taboo noise into the pit. Yeah, so you went to knock them into the pit. Okay. Oh god, shadows. Also, B has no pins anymore. B now no longer has any pins. Oh, sorry, Neku. This feels like cheating. Okay, Ron. Run! Get up, okay. I'm not even getting cards anymore with B. Like, I'm literally just trying to dodge her on the bottom screen while Bait just beats shit out of her ever so slowly. Go into the air. Try and get air combos on her if she's gonna be up in the air. Get up. Oh god. This is hurting my hands so much. This is so painful on my hands to try and do all this at once. It is hard to do this for extended periods of time is what I'm learning. Oh god. Okay. How's Byte working on a single screen? I'm very curious. I'm curious how the whole game works on a single screen, honestly. Like, there's so many parts of the game that have stuff like that happening where there's, like, one thing happens. Like, I mean, even the bat fights. The bat fights are the fucking same. In the ones that happened in A East. Those were the same where on one screen you attack the big bat, on the other one you attack, like, little bits of noise. I got some bling. Oh, I got her noise! I got the rhyme noise! Yeah.
Yo, man, we in trouble.
Oh, I thought I had to tap the pin. I thought I had to tap the pin. Tap, okay. I still have no idea what to do. Hey! I did it, I got her at one point. I don't know what I did. I have no idea what to do. Neku's shadow? Shadow? Oh! No, I have no idea. No, I don't get it. No, I still don't get it. I have no idea what you... I see the shadow, but I still have no idea what that means. I still have no idea what I'm actually meant to do. She's in the opposite direction to where my shadow is, but like where? I'm digging it. Like she's just somewhere in that direction? That doesn't seem very helpful. Hey! Like she's just somewhere over away from where the shadow is?
I'm digging it!
That fight was weird, and it's still going.
At least we won.
No, we're back. Okay. I have no idea how I feel about that fight.
That's how it's done.
Like, it is, like, introducing new mechanics that are just, like, just work it out. It's fucking, like... I don't know how I feel about that fight. Like, just... chucking rhyme is cool, like, it's cool, like, oh, you get rhyme's noise, and you can, like, use rhyme, to attack. But it's just like, okay, the shadow's pointing away from where she is, so just attack somewhere over there, and you might hit her, maybe, who fucking knows? I feel like the execution of that concept could have been significantly better than what it was. It kinda just felt awkward. It kind of just felt awkward. The first part, I just forgot cast the tabby noise into the pit to make her vulnerable. I forgot that part. But, like, that last part is just chuck the noise somewhere over there and it might hit. And also the fact that it's a fight where you can't heal, like, after the first phase, is pretty brutal and feels like it goes against the point of the game. Like, you can't get fusions to heal, you can't have any pins to heal, you just have to go through several phases where you're trying to work out new mechanics without being able to heal. So, yeah. Imagine if I did that on level 1, I wouldn't even be able to heal in that last part, I would have died in like 2 hits. A lot of 10,000 yen, and some Scarletite. How? An error in my analysis? Bakana. Sucks for you. How could you have risen above my projections? You're not a Reaper. How did you summon that noise? Like I know. I'm good with pins. I'm good with psychs. It's been Neku's whole deal this whole time. And she's not a noise. She's our friend Rhyme. All of this on account of that stupid chimp. If only I destroyed him. I don't think any of us can predict what Beat will do. I mean, look at him. Rhyme! I'm so sorry. This is all my fault. I'll never let go again. Just you wait. I'm gonna give you that second chance, I swear. What a touching reunion. But ponder this. Would your sister care as much about you in return? We took her love for you. It was your entry fee. Oh. Beat's entry fee was how much Rhyme cared for him. Oh.
Huh?
You what? Your sister's memories of you, they were your entry fee. Hers was something else. You must not have been very dear to her. What? That look on your face. It's just as I predicted. And she's gone. Rhyme's memory of me were my entry fee? Then what was hers, yo? Screw it, I ain't got time to think. We gotta push ahead. Right. More mail. From who? See you in the composer's chamber. Who you think it's... Mr. H? Yo, Neku, let's move. Right. Shit's getting serious. Shit is getting very serious. But we're definitely gonna save after that, because I did the fight! I was at level 20, but if I was even one level lower, I probably would have died, because I wasn't allowed to heal. Alright, well, we're across the Rubicon now. Clever reference, huh? The composer must be ahead. Once we go in, I don't think we can come back. I ain't sitting out here. You ready, man? I'm as ready as I'm gonna fucking be. I've got all my shit set up. I can't think of anything else that I need to do. So I'm gonna go on anyway. You get the strangest feeling this is your last chance to turn back. I saved it. I'm good. Full speed ahead. I appreciate games that give you a warning. You're about to enter the end of the game. I appreciate when games do that. Just a big fuck off warning sign. Oi! End of the game. Do shit before you do this. Full speed ahead. Trail of the Bygone.
Huh?
Someone's walking. Wait. What's wrong, yo? Behind us. Something's coming. Oh, what is this place? It's so dark and spooky and stinky. What? Excuse me, what? Neku, Beat, what? How are you here? Who's disguising themselves as Shiki, or what actually happened to make her come back? What are you doing here? I just woke up here all by myself. Maybe? I mean, we did just defeat the Game Master for the week. It would make sense if we just won. But we're still in here, because shit's fucky. Does that mean we won the game? Like, the Iron Maiden was the last boss? But if I won the game, why hasn't Shiki come back to life? Good point, she is also still in the UG. Did the Reapers trick me? Or... So where are we? Are we all alive again? No, not yet. This is the Shibuya River in the UG. Huh? The UG? But why? I'm supposed to be alive. You can blame me. They made you my entry fee. I'm sorry.
Huh?
Huh? I was your entry fee? Then...
Oh.
Whoa, so I'm the... What? Oh, Neku! Talk about embarrassing! I'm the most important thing to you, what? I mean, this isn't like you at all. That's because you haven't seen me in 2 weeks. You missed a lot. And I mean a lot, Shiki. Well, look on the bright side. If we're together now, you must have won, right? Now we can both come back to life. Not yet. What? Why not? We beat the Game Master. But I haven't been taken to that white room. Probably because we're breaking rules left and right. I'm pretty sure the game's null and void at this point. I'm pretty sure we're just doing shit now. The game is just so far beyond what this is. No, but what about our lives? There might still be a way, yo. If I become the next composer. How does that work? I gotta take the guy with the job now. I say? You don't seem surprised. Not really. You both look so serious. So I guess that must be the only way. Don't worry, yo. I'm gonna pull this thing off. I know, Beat. Let's not waste any time then. Oh, it's good to have her back. It's good to have her back. If the composer stands between me and life, then he has to go. I have to do it. Neku, let's go! Coming. Oh, onwards we fucking march. More hate piles. Look, there's something there. One of Pie Face's heaps? Let's check it out. They removed my save option. They removed my save option. Really is a point of no return. They don't want you saving after that and fucking yourself over. Good video game. Smart idea. Smart idea. Oh my gosh, there's a person under there. Minami? What the fuck? Grim Heaper got crunched. No way, man. That guy was tough as bricks. We could have done this to him. You think Shades? Could he have done this? I don't know. But whoever it was must have been more powerful. But like, yo, we lucky, right? Don't be so morbid. But we don't gotta beat him now. No, just the guy who's stronger. Details, yo. I'm telling you, we lucky. Now let's keep going. What happened here? I mean, it looks like he got rocked hard. Oh my god, Pieface's cap. I'll buy a chance upon this cap. A Minamimoto fave. It's like calculated and will make you Zeta math whiz. Maybe. Well, I haven't gotten a good hat this entire fucking game. How good is his hat? It's pretty fucking good. It's pretty fucking good. Yeah, get rid of the boots. Minami, in your honor, I will carry forth your hat. I will carry your hat into battle, Minami. Onwards we go. This horse screams endgame. We're almost there, Rhyme. Hang on just a little longer. I guess Shiggy's not questioning how we're able to save Rhyme or anything. She's just like on board of, okay, she's going down. Let's just deal with it. Neku, you all right? You look pale. I'll be okay. Come on. Let's go. Did that say Dead God's Pad? This is the composer's pad. This is where we've seen the cutscenes when they're talking to each other. Is this the composer's pad? Wait, I know this place. And this is, yeah, this is where it is. Shades. Shades, what's up, buddy? We're above a fucking tank of piranhas also, it would seem. Okay, I had to check whether I could scan the fucking... the fucking conductor. Welcome, players. You're not meant to be here. Ex-players, that is. Your game has ended. Now you are simply dead. We won! We fucking won! It's him. What you doing here, Shades? Where's the composer? Oh, is that why you're here? And why would you kids want to meet the composer? What do you think, man? We're gonna take him down. Not a chance. You're not even fit to look upon him. What you say? The composer's utmost concern is mankind's happiness. He exists to shepherd the human race toward the right future. And thus all his acts are motivated by boundless love. Is the composer actually God? Like, God, God? You think egotists like yourselves have the right to lay your eyes, let alone a finger, on a being so far above you? You're not even on the same plane. You don't get a word you saying, but you ain't stopping me. I'm gonna take his place and bring everybody back to life. You see, that self-serving rubbish is the root of all pain. What? egotism, disregard for others, has caused Shibuya's downfall. And now the composer must rebuild from scratch. None may stand in the way of that noble goal. Okay, so the composer is planning on literally just destroying Shibuya and rebuilding it. Yeah, okay. Ugh. Ah! What happened? Shiki! You motherfucker! You motherfucker! What'd you do to Shiki? No! No! What the fuck? What the fuck? Partner on partner fight time. Literally, you can see her. She's doing the fucking moves that we did when she was our partner. Like the throwing and the uppercuts and shit. God damn it. Oh. Shades. Keita, whatever your fucking name is. You're an asshole. I'm shaking so much, the entire table shaking. Good thing I have that new microphone with a shock panel, although I don't know if it's helping. Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ, the damage is real. Jesus Christ, the damage is real. I might need to actually put myself up to my proper level. It is slightly possible I might need to put myself up to my proper level. Maybe. Maybe. I am not doing much damage. Attack! Get him there! Spam every attack that we possibly have! Boom, 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 boom! Hell yeah, get in there! Oh, jeez. Oh, Jesus. Okay, fusion attack! Fusion attack! Get in there! That's a free heal. That's a free fucking heal. Part of a heal, at least. I am noticing that beat is getting absolutely rocked by Shaky. I am definitely noticing that, don't worry. Fortunately, Neku seems to be unable to take damage from this dude! So, as long as we kill them fast enough, we'll be fine, right? I'm digging it! Okay, no, I can absolutely take damage from this dude. Never mind. Get in there. I wish I could work out and get fusions more reliably, but they're very difficult. I'm digging it. Please, man. There we go. It's more than I wanted to recharge more than anything. Come on, just keep attacking him, and he'll be stunned so much that he'll die. What's he doing? He paused time! He froze time and then died immediately afterwards. And I'm worried about that image because it looks like we're erasing Shiki while we're doing this. Also, I fucking crushed you.
Such power.
Such power. Matama. And a song about something about a star. I heard the word star a lot. Lightning Rook. Fire lightning in the direction, inflicts damage on contact. We're still getting new pins, by the way. Got him! I see now why he picked you. Ugh. Composer's next! But Shiki! What the hell? She's still around at the very least? Shiki? Damn. She don't recognize us. Why can't she? How did she not get erased when conducted it? Wait, she has one on too. If I break it. So good, man. Girl could be trying to kill us. We had options. Shiki, forgive me. Stop. Don't you touch her. Slip it behind you. Ah, you got the pin! I should stop Shiki. I was right. It was the pin. The composer. Mr. H's pin. B, wake up! He took the brunt of Shiki's attack. They're both out cold. Shiki, the Reapers, even Shibuya. How can Mr. H use them? Why? It doesn't make any sense. But I have to keep fighting like this. But I do have to. Alone. Now, where's the composer? Our partners are actually just gone. Jesus. I mean, they're not gone, but like, yeah, they're not out. But Tama, draw a circle, aim space, angle attack with spinning slash, draw, nah. I was still getting new pins right now, which is interesting. See, here's my biggest concern, right? I can't save before, just hardcore KO'd. Yeah, just knocked the fuck out cold. Here's my concern. If I go to whatever the next fight is, and I leave myself at level 20, the only way to re-level myself is to redo that fight as well. So do I level myself up now and risk the final fight being too easy? Or do I keep myself at this level and risk having to be like, okay, way too hard, I have to level myself back up and having to redo this fight? That being said, if I redo this fight, I could just level myself up to max so I know I beat it, and then I can just choose whatever level I want to do next. And I'll just max help my level myself for this fight again, so I can just do it a lot easier. I mean, I still did it just quite fine just then. Fuck it, we'll leave it at 20. Wait, I actually don't know where to go. Skin? Ah. There we go. Trail of the Judged. Yep, that artwork on the... There it is! There it is. Sorry, let's just recreate when Neku died for a second. Or he wants to listen to his music, I guess, instead. Never mind. This graffiti. I remember, Mr. H. Your art kept me going. Every piece seemed to shout, "Enjoy life!" And outside my headphones, the rest of the world heard it too. It was fun just standing here, looking. When I found out you were Cat, man, I just shook. I mean, I knew you were different the second I met you. The things you said, just somehow they clicked. I thought I finally met a guy I could respect. And now look. But I won't falter anymore. You taught me better than that. Watch it not be him. Watch it not be him. Shiki, Bait, even Joshua, Rhyme, everybody. They got me this far. Now, it's my fight. Onwards we go. Room of Reckoning. Look at this fucking Kingdom Hearts shit. Jesus Christ. The Three Towers. It's the logo of, it's the white, it's the outline for the logo of the game. Hey. This place. Come on out, composer. Fight me. You want me to defeat you, right? Isn't that it? Then show yourself. Show yourself and fight. Mr. H. Who's Mr. H? You again? But I just beat you. You're back? I'm amazed. Here you stand on the final stage, and you don't know who's playing what? What do you mean? All right, you want answers? First off, the composer is not the man you envision. Second, the composer is not here, and hasn't been since before you came to the UG. So sorry you missed, capital letter, him. I have been in charge of the UG since his departure. Mr. Hanakoma is not the composer? Then you're responsible. For many things, yes. Why? Why would you do this to Shibuya? Oh, Neku, don't you like music? Huh? Music requires many things: melody, performers, instruments. But the key element in most divine music is a conductor to hold it all together. The world is very much the same. Ah, so the roles, yeah, they're literally composer and conductor because music's really good in this game. Under one conductor, one ideal, the world of men marches toward bliss. God, now you're sounding like the fucking people who were brainwashed by the pins. Didn't you feel it in Shibuya? Rage, hate, misery, envy, fear, self-deprecation, a cacophony of countless selfish wants. All that noise swells, it turns into crime, warfare. All the world's ills can be traced to individuality. Oh, that's where we're going with this. Ah, that's where we're going with this. Ills? By tearing down the differences between us, I can make the world a paradise. By making everybody think alike? That's not even possible. It is possible with these pins. The red skull pins. You're behind that too? I base them on the composer's player pin. You see, the eyes of the world are on Shibuya. What street starts on these streets will spread across the globe. I can save all of mankind from right here. Shibuya shall be my podium. I know you'll love what I do with it. Now, if you'll just remove that player pin, huh? It neutralizes the effects of the red skull pin. Oh, so that's why I was so firing before. So my imprinting can't reach you. This protects me? All this time it was... What have your dealings with other people brought you? Only hurt. Join me. Help me build a new Shibuya. Fuck you, suck my dick. Fuck you, I'll never help you. Maybe living in your Shibuya would be easier. Maybe. Except one problem. It wouldn't be Shibuya. I was never good with people. I covered my ears and blocked them out. But you know what? If I don't clash, I don't change. The world ends at my borders. The world ends with me. And the best moments slip away. Shibuya is full of people waiting for those moments. When we can clash together and find something new. Here in the UG, I clashed. I changed. And now I know, Shibuya should stay just as it is. Then let me ask you this. Do you like people? Yes! Fucking love them! In some individual people, no, but people as a whole, yes! Why you would is beyond me. I think you need to be reformed. Save your energy. An unpartnered player has little to no power. You can't stop me.
Yeah.
Can't move. Remember that I'm saving you. This pin was standing between you and freedom from pain. Now bask in the light of true redemption. Don't! Welcome to the new Shibuya. He crushed it. He crushed my little button. How dare you?
Huh?
Nothing happened. What? But I destroyed your player pin. Why can't I imprint on you? I'm a fool. Of course he wouldn't let me harm his pick. Whose pick? I owe you no more explanations. Only destruction. Yo, 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 I don't think so. Ain't you forgetting somebody? Here comes the Beat Wagon! Hey, woke up. Beat, Cheeky! I told you, yo. Ain't no one gonna be the composer but me. How could you go on without us, Neckers? Fuck yeah, remix of the intro song! How could you go on without us, Neck? Who are your partners? Now what would Mr. H say about partners? trust him? That's better. Look at this partner crap. You ain't my partner anymore, man. You're my friend. I mean, in the way that I use those terms, partner is definitely closer than... beside the point. So trust that, yo. B. come on, Neku. We've still got work to do. Yeah. Mr. Ringleader here. We're just gonna take Shades out, right? Hell yes, we do. Yeah, unknown. Right. The three of us can do it. Now let's take our lives back. Get him! I'm this close. Once I erase these three, Shibuya will be saved. Come to me then. Come meet your end. Oh, we are gonna fuck you up, bro. And there's his wings. And oh, they're evil wings. Even more evil than usual. Was that a fucking... Oh my god, it's a giant fuck-off dragon! We're controlling Shiki! We're controlling Shiki! We're controlling Shiki, woo! Get the face! Get its face! Get the face! Get the face! Fusion attack! Get in there! Yeah! We get fusions way more fucking frequently with Shiki! Where's the dragon? I see your tail. There you are! Oh, okay, it goes from screen to screen. Okay, got it. You're unknown. Come on. Burn! Burn! Fusion attack again! Die, you bitch! Yeah, get in there, plush toy attack. Can I attack the... I can! I can ever so slightly hurt the body. I can't do the slash attack on it because of the way it works, but I can do this. Better go. There it is! Ah! Okay, no, actually. That one didn't. That one is! There we go! I'm gonna do it. There we go. Just wanted to make sure that one's on recharge. Just get in there! Get the face! Get the big ugly face! Oh god, oh god, I'm in a bubble! I don't wanna be in a bubble! Get rid of the bubble! Fusion attack out of the bubble! Die! Hey, got me out of the bubble! Attack, there we go. Now we switch over to beat. Hell yeah. Get back in there! Get in there, beat! I'll shoot the tail a little bit. Yeah. Hell yeah. Is there any more tail parts I can attack here? Not at the moment, no. I got them all. Oh, there they are! Ah, get the tail! Get the tail! That tail's gone again. There's the tail! Burn the tail! Burn the tail alive! Yes! Die by the flames! Yeah! Come down to this screen! Let me hit you with my big powerful pins! Let me hit you with my big powerful pins, you bastard! Fusion attack, fuck yeah. Get the heals in. Hell yeah. We're not even fusion attacking anything right now, but hey, it will heal me. I'll take it. I did hurt it, hell yeah. Burn the tail! Yeah, it's not letting me actually attack. There we go. You decided to come down here, you fucking coward. Hell yeah. Hell yeah! Oh god. Burn! Burn your dumb, stupid fucking face! Slash at your face! Attack the bubble! There we go. We got through the bubble, we're good. Oh, I can attack the tail like this! It does let me do that, it's just a little bit harder. Yeah! Yeah! Burn! Get out of the way of the bubble, hell yeah. Hell yeah. Keep it going. Alright. Okay, we're gonna... Oh, wrong time to heal. There we go. We've healed. We're good. Get in there. Noise erased. Didn't even disappear. Didn't even get an animated. Didn't even get anything for it. It just said erased because I did a bunch of damage. Part was yet unknown. And I got a hip snake. I just killed a pretty hip snake. No. I must keep fighting. My time is almost up.
Huh? What?
Joshua? Your timer must be nearly ticked out. Joshua? You're alive? Why are you here? What? What? Excuse me, what? Huh? What? Not done, not yet. I will protect Shibuya. Going on the screen at one given time that it cannot be reasonable for me to do anything about this. Jesus Christ. I'm only controlling one character right now and it's still too much. What the fuck? It is so hard to dodge these attacks. There's so much happening at once. Ah, Jesus fucking Christ. Burn, 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 burn. Everything must burn. Everything must die. Get out of here. Gonna fucking kill you. The shit out. Please heal. Oh my god. Oh my god. No thank you. I'm stuck on a burn blaze. Yo, Shiki! Shiki's back. Shiki saves me, I think. I'm not 100% sure what happened there, but I got saved, I think. Burn! 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 I'll be honest, I have no idea what's going on right now. I'm trying my best to survive and I don't know how to. Please die. Okay. Shoot the bullet, shoot the bullet, shoot the bullet, set the bullet, set the bullet, set the bullet. Jesus Christ. There is way too much going on right now. Okay, just keep going attacked. B! I must not fail. Get in there! Oh, Jesus. We're taking a lot of damage here. Get out. Okay, there we go. Okay, dodge out of the way. Get in there with some attacks. Oh, dear God. Oh, dear God. Oh, dear God. Okay. Get out of the- oh my god, the bubble. The bubble, the fucking bubble, I swear to god. Ah! Everything dies. The bubble's not dead. Bubble's very not dead. Bubble's not dying. Jesus Christ! Fucking Christ! What am I even meant to do? everything?
Now Shibuya will be saved.
What the fuck? What the fuck? What the actual fuck? What the fuck? What are you meant to do there? What are you even meant to do? Alright, well, I'm just gonna do a little bit of that. I'm gonna do a bit of that, and I'm gonna go back in there. So I guess we'll just redo all the fights, and hopefully crush them. And, oh my god, okay. Now I'm just going max level and just trying my best. What the ever-loving fuck? What the fuck? There's a lot of dialogue to skip now that I had to re-level myself. Which is kind of a massive issue with this part of the game. When you do retry, it just immediately kicks you back into it. So if you want to, like, even outside the level stuff, if you wanted to change your pins, you have to redo all the fights and dialogue before it. And that kind of sucks. That's annoying. Like, it should be an option. If you retry, you can go into the menu before you retry. Not, you have to go through this much dialogue and fights and everything just to try a different loadout on the boss. That sucks, and that's bad. Like, it's going to take me, like, 10 minutes. It's going to take me, like, 10 minutes to get back to reattempting that fight with all the dialogue and everything that I have to go through. Like, not joking. I have to do two fights plus all the dialogue up to that point that I'm just tapping as fast as I can through. This is going to take 10 minutes to retry it, even if I just wanted a different pin. That is something they added for Neo, at least. Thank God, because this blows and this is bad. I honestly don't know how they didn't consider that. I honest to God don't know how this wasn't something they considered. I get not letting you save right now because then you fuck over your save file, but maybe that's why the game should have multiple save files or something. But I'm just gonna go on max level and try my best. Honest to God, with how that fight was going, I was assuming it was a you're not meant to win fight, and then a cutscene would happen that gets your friends back, but nothing was happening there. Like, that fight is going to take 10 minutes on its own as well. Alright, how little damage did I do? It's gonna take a while. It's gonna take a while. Like, part of me is considering, should I put on more healing pins so I have more than 3 heals throughout the fight? Although I have way more health, I'll need to heal less often. It will give, like, healing will give me more health back. It's a lot of dialogue that I have to skip through. Huh? Like, literally wanting to use a different pin, you have to do all this. I underleveled myself and I'm having to redo this because I underleveled myself, and I get that. But also, even if you just wanted to try a different pin, you have to go through all this. And that's bad. That's bad, and that sucks, and that I don't like. Burn! Dash attacks! I'm get over that. Slash attack. Get him with the slash attack. Get him with all of that shit. Get him with the taps. Get him with the burn. Yeah. Get him with the burn. Get him with the whoop 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 whoop. Wait. There we go. Whoop 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 whoop. Yeah. Oh, the engine got fun. Banging the last bit of the flame off is annoying sometimes. Oh my god, he actually did this before the very end of the fucking fight this time around. Wow. I can't believe that's how long it took me to see that last time. Because it was literally right at the end of the fight that he decided not to do it. Okay, get over there. Oh my god, dash. Dash in that. In that. Yeah. Come on, So even this is gonna take a while because I have to do, like, I have to go through all of this to, like, the fights aren't quick.
Try harder.
Also, somehow this fight's been going on this long and I still don't have a single fusion by just randomly mashing. Ah! Damn it, video game.
I'm digging it!
There we go. Put Cho's hat back on after this. I already put it on. I paused it and I put it on. Unless I chose the wrong item.
Try harder.
I'm digging it.
Come on, get in there. Burn. Please burn. Burn harder. Ah, Slash Tag. He's almost dead to Slash Tag. And there we go. Again, remember, you have to do this if you want to try a different loadout. That's dumb and bad. Like, I'm honestly worried that I'm in a position where the very end of the game is going to ruin the game for me because it's dumb. Like, I'm legitimately worried that the end of the game is going to be so bullshit annoying that I'm just going to be like, get to the end of the game and just be like, ugh, finally. I'm legitimately worried about that. Because this isn't good. But I'm thinking for the fight against them, I should take off my dash pin and just replace it with a different heal. If I'm even able to do that. Because you can't have two pins that have the same psych on that are like same level or something. So I may not even be able to put on more than that, but I'll try. Because the dash attack's not going to be doing a ton of damage to the dragon. It doesn't do much damage to begin with. It's good for stunlocking a bunch of stuff and just doing damage while you're moving out of the way. But healing an extra three times would probably be worth it. Yeah, Show's hats on. Now, what are the heals? Cookie's a heal. Is secure drink bay. Cure immobility, small amount of health, store HP. I only want... They're all one use. They're only one use, because I haven't actually mastered any of the other ones. They're all only one use. It gives me one extra heal. Like, they're literally one use. Yeah, and I can't even put it on. Never mind. I actually can't put them on. Never mind, I can't even put on a different heal. I'll stick with what I have then. Oh, this is... Oh, God, this is gonna suck. This is gonna suck real bad. Like, if it just gets to a point where it's just, like, the final boss is just such a difficulty spike and it just takes forever that I just get the option to knock it down to easy after, like, five attempts, I will just do that. I'll just do that. Like, it lets you retry on easy, and I know it would probably be lame to, at the very end of the game, to just retry the final boss on easy, but honestly, with the design of this, I don't want to have to redo all of this again, ever. So once I get into this fight, I'm just going to keep retrying it until I win. And if that requires knocking it down in easy, I'll do that. I'm on max level right now. I have a fuck ton more health. I have, like, the best pins that I've gotten throughout the game. If this isn't good enough to beat the game on normal for me, then I'll do it on easy. Like, currently, I am not lacking this. Although the main reason I'm not liking it is just because of how much bullshit, like how much fluff I have to go through here. Like, I have to go through this much dialogue to retry with a different thing. That's bad. Like, that's really... Sorry, it's the only thing running through my mind right now is just like, wow, this design sucks. And that's annoying, because I've enjoyed so much of this game so far, but just this moment right here. I mean, like, I've had to go back to the title screen to do other stuff to, like, level myself back up before. But it's never been this many fights in a row with this much dialogue leading up to it. Like, I'm literally just tapping the screen over and over again. Can I skip cutscenes? Yeah, there's no cutscene skip. There's no cutscene skip, so... This is unskippable cutscenes. On several boss fights in a row. to try a different loadout. Like, aggressively bad. Like, it's not just like it's a little annoying, it's like aggressively awful.
Huh? What?
Ooh, oh. This is so long! It's so long! It's fuck. Like, again, you can say it's fair, I underleveled myself or what was the final boss or coming close to it. I should have put myself on top level. But again, even outside of that, just I want to try a different pin. I didn't realize the final boss was going to be several heads standing in one place. This one particular pin I have isn't that good. I would like to try a different pin for this fight because of what it is. Still gotta go through this much. And two boss fights during it. Because we gotta defeat Kida like three times in a row. Twice while he's a dragon. Where is his tails? I'm not seeing any tails down here. There's some tails! Get the tails! There it is! Beat up the head! Shoot the head! Shot the head! Burn the head! Slash attack the head! Ow! You're doing a lot of damage! Die! Fusion attack! There's some tail over here. On a tail action. Kida, give me that tail action! There we go. Get the tail! There it goes. Slash! Get him again! More fusion! Where's your tail? There it is! I literally just pushed it off screen. Didn't attack it off screen. I literally just pushed it off screen. Beat time! Ready for a beatdown? Ready for a beatdown? It's funny, I swear to God. So funny. It's so funny. So fucking hilarious. Oh, his head's up here. Get the head! Aim for the head! That is actually one of the most powerful ones that I've got right now. But the flame and the slashing ones are actually the most powerful things that I currently have. Fusion attack. There we go. There we go. Okay. Aim for the tail. Get the tail. Alright, that part of the tail's gone. There's my tail. Get the other parts of the tail. Head. Get over there. Yeah. Get in there. Yeah. I got to attack the head for like 2 seconds. What the heck? Boom, 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 boom. Ah, fucking slash fail. But I'm really bad at using the last bit of the burn. I'm really bad at that. I keep leaving it with just the tiniest little bit left on it that I just don't use because it never comes or never refreshes. There we go. There we go. There we go. Alright, are we ready? Are we ready? After a significant amount of time has passed. To try the final fight again. Assuming it's the final fight. Huh? Assuming it's the final fight. Also, Joshua's possibly the composer? Which, if that's the case, how did they not... When they were talking before, how they not realize that he was the composer? Like, when he was like, Neku's teamed up with someone, and they're alive, what the fuck's going on? Assuming Joshua's the composer. Which is what this is implying. Alright, now, when we last did this and I died, I did maybe 10% of its health. Watch yourself. So this is still going to be brutally difficult. But we'll see how it goes. Like, I have to actually just focus a lot on trying to dodge attacks. So I'm doing very badly right now that I'm in this bubble. I'm already in a bubble. There we go. I'm going out of the bubble and immediately got bit. Ah. Burn, 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 burn. Yeah, I don't know how to dodge attacks. There's so much going on that, like, trying to dodge attacks, that means just means I'm never going to be attacking myself. So, don't know that's the thing I'm going to be doing much of. So, there's some differences between this and anime. Blood during the boss fight, I was going to start watching the anime. This isn't great, also, so far. I've really enjoyed the game so far, but this boss seems, unfair. To such an absurd degree. This seems actually unfair. I'm still almost dying, like, already, by the way. Like, I may just never beat this game. I think I'm just not gonna beat this game. I don't know if I can physically do this. Like, how much damage I am taking and, like, how little I am doing is just... Does the main head take more damage or something? I can't even attack the main head. It would seem I cannot even... No, it seems basically the same. No, it's got to be something I'm missing. There has to be something that I am missing here. This cannot be how this actually is. There's got to be something that I am missing to this fight. This can't actually be how it is. This is ridiculous. Look at how little damage I've done. I've got to be missing something. This can't be the actual... There's got to be a gimmick somewhere in this fight that you're meant to do to actually get damage off on it. I mean, maybe something to do when the partners appear, because I don't even know what they're doing when they appear. The partners are appearing and I don't actually know what's happening. Like, I don't even know what's happening when the partners are appearing. So... Yeah. Please stack the head a bit more. Oh my god. This is honestly god gonna take like 20 minutes to just actually kill it. How was I remember the first game, so I could jump in the new. I didn't have any version of the first game, so I really only had one option, the anime. I mean, I don't... Like, there's clearly something... What? This can't actually just be how this is. I refuse to believe that this is the intentional, like, thing that you're meant to do here. I refuse to believe that this is just how the final boss is. And it is actually just this. Because... Press directions for the partners who've done fusion so far. Left for Shiki, right for B. Wait, what? I can... Okay, I'm pressing buttons and nothing's happening. I'm pressing buttons and nothing's happening. Yeah, I don't know what's happening. I'm kind of mashing the D-pad right now while just while I'm trying to do this. And yeah. What do I do? It's not even taking damage. Look at how little there is left. They're supposed to give you a light pot that boosts your attacks further. I know. I mean, yeah, boosting my attack would make sense if that was a thing they could do, but, I'm pressing buttons, like... I'm pressing left for Shiki and nothing's happening? What a- Beat, hi! So I press right for beat now? Times 4 attack! I'm getting times 4 attack, I think. Burn everything! I've got no idea. I have no idea. I don't understand, and I have times 4. What am I doing to do that? I'm pressing, do I just press buttons and it just gives me bonuses? Because if that's happening, I'm not noticing it. Look, there's a, Okay, don't get near the main head, because the main head does so much damage. That's bad. Other division, you press their buttons to just keep boosting your attack. Okay. So you just have to wait until they do a fusion? Can you prop their fusion by doing anything? Also, how are you meant to know what their buttons are? I don't understand. Like, is it based on the previous fight? Because, like, the Shiki was attacking to the right in the previous fight. I mean, like, I'm almost dead, and they haven't even done a fusion yet, so... So... Their fusions come at HP, the threshold their buttons are based on the top screen. Where on the top screen? Okay, there's a fusion up there. Oh, they're in the- I didn't even see them in- Oh, they're in the palms of it. I didn't even notice them in there. I thought that was just a fucking dragon picture on the top. I didn't even fucking notice that they were in the bubbles in the dude's fucking hand. I honest to God didn't even notice that. I didn't even notice they were in there. Okay, so now I'm just gonna mash left as much as I can to get as much life up as I can. That's my plan. Dodging attacks is still really hard. No, get me out of the bubble! I didn't mean to tap the heal button. Whoops. I accidentally tapped the heal button while I was trying to tap the shoot. Time for attack. Okay. Okay. There we go. Go again. So hard to block the attacks. look at how much shit's going on down there. And I'm meant to be dodging this attack. Oh, okay. Okay, so a flash on the screen appears, and then one of them will have a thing to give you. Okay, okay. Okay. If you see the screen flash, you'll look at the top screen, and then there's a thing that appears up there. Got it. Okay. Okay, I'm understanding a little bit more now. Okay, come down. Oh, there we go. Yeah, you can. Okay, the screen flashes. They appear. Okay. I didn't notice them up there before. This made a lot less sense. Okay. So we'll just start doing more and more damage as we go along. Okay. I get it now. Okay. There's an actual gimmick to this fight. There's an actual thing. Well, I don't even know if it's a gimmick, but like there's an actual method of what you're meant to do during this fight. Okay. There it is. Okay. There's an actual thing you're meant to be doing, and it is reasonable with that. I didn't notice that before. Now that I've noticed it, it'll be significantly more reasonable. Because I definitely did not notice that before. Joshua! Oh, and Joshua's up! Oh, so Joshua's like, even though he's possessed in there, he's still giving us the power. Nice! Yeah, let's go! All of their powers combined! I'm so glad I'm at max level though, because oh my god, the amount of damage this fucking thing does. And it's very hard to dodge the attacks on it. I didn't mean to heal again. I think that's the second time I made that exact mistake. Alright, we have no heals for the rest of the fight. Oh, there we go. And I'm not getting any more than plus 5, but it's probably worthwhile to keep doing that, so you can just keep the attacks up as high as you can. It is still going to take a while to slowly whittle this thing down, even with plus 5 attack. It is still going to take a decent while to whittle down that much fucking health. Wait, there we go. Burn everything. Burn. Okay, so yeah, the bubble is just, it's going to drag you towards the head to be eaten. It seems to be what it is. Alright, Shiki, get in there. Any last words? It's very hard to... Dodging the bubble is hard as hell, and it drags you into the most damaging attack. Get in there! Come on. Beat. There we go. Okay. This one might be a fail because I didn't understand what to do for a long time, and I also did waste two of my heals. But if we lose on this one, we'll at least understand what's going on. Next time, we'll have a much better chance. We'll have a much better chance next time. Okay. Yeah. Now that I'm aware of what I'm actually meant to be doing for it, significantly more reasonable. Come on. Yes, did we do it? Fusion Star! All four together! Let's fucking go! Eat the power of friendship, bitch! Oh, shit. Boom! Ultimate Fusion! Get fucking rocked! Okay, understanding that there was an actual mechanic for that final fight made it significantly better. I still don't like having to reset if you want to try something ever so slightly different, but it was significantly better now that I understood that. Bottom screen only win. I mean, one, I didn't realize that was a mechanic. But two, that... I did use the top screen, just, you know, to press some buttons. Okay, you know, that fight is fine now that I understand that there's an actual mechanic to increase your health. I thought it was literally just going to be the longest endurance run ever. Okay, knowing that that's actually there, fight's fine. I still don't like having to restart the thing for that. That is still a design that pisses me off. But that's gone away because we're now able to do that. Oh, God. It seems I've won. No! It can't end like this. Who else will protect Shibuya? He has a timer on his hand, like the players? A timer? Why does he have a timer? Then you'll do as you intended? End Shibuya? But Composer, sir, why? I've decided to wash my hands of it. It has no future value to me or anyone else. So I'm shutting it down. Wait, sir, Shibuya is still full of so many possibilities. Yes, and people too dull and clouded to see them. Shibuya's influence is too strong. I have to end it now, before the other grounds are poisoned and all is lost. Other grounds? So much world building's gonna happen right now, I feel like. Then the problem is the people. If they change to something more suitable, you'd stay your hands? Yes, but that's clearly beyond them. Sir, give me a chance to prove you wrong. Always capitalized you, by the way. I swear I'll remake Shibuya in a way that will please you. A game, then. The game? That's right. The rules will be simple. If you manage to fix Shibuya, you win. Shibuya stays. And if I can't fix it, then you lose, Megumi. You and Shibuya will be erased. That's alright. If I can risk my life to protect Shibuya, I will. But what chance do I have of beating you? Relax, Megumi. I'll be sure to handicap myself. I'll retreat to the RG, and I won't challenge you directly. Well, I don't want to guess that, don't I? But I will pick a player to represent me. Since you've piqued my interest with this talk of rebuilding, expect me to be watching from the sidelines. Very well, sir. I'll enter your game. Then first, I'll need to collect your entry fee. You have 1 month, Megumi. I wish you nothing but success. Jesus fucking Christ. You're going to erase it. The streets I know and love. Gone. You did well, Megumi. That was one of my more enjoyable games. I gave it my all, sir. I have no regrets. You know, I liked your idea. Shame it didn't work out. You gave me a wonderful opportunity. Thank you, sir. What the fuck is going on? As for you, well played, player. I still can't fathom why my imprinting failed to affect you. Because I was picked. Me neither. Wait, that's right.
What?
And oh, he grabbed another one at some point, didn't he? Why do you have two? I only gave you the one. Haha, of course. Neku. It's up to you now. Huh? Joshua? What's going on? All of this was a game. One set up by me. What? Then that means you're... Let me make it obvious. I suppose they'll serve. What's happening? I can't move, yo. What? Beat Chiki! It was me, Neku. I'm Shibuya's composer. And he teamed up with us on the second week. Joshua! Joshua, why to everything? But that can't be. Week one day when Neku realized he had two of them and it never came up again until now. Oh, it was on the first day he had two? Oh, I did not realize that. But that can't be. I know that must unsettle you, especially since we spent all that quality time together. Still, it's the truth, and I need you to face it. Megumi and I decided to play this game to determine if Shibuya should exist or not. Then everything I've done. All of it. You were playing for my team. Really, you did a bang-up job. I couldn't have won without you. What have I done? I had one role in this game. Picking the player who would play for me. One boy from the RG. Me? Very sharp, Neku. Give yourself a hand. I knew I picked a winner. But it was Pieface that killed me. His bullet was meant for me. For some time now, he's been after my sake. Maybe he thought I could be killed in the RJ? A gross miscalculation. The composer, unlike the Reapers, can use some of his power in the living worlds. So poor Minami Moto failed and fled back to the UG. But I liked keeping him around. He knows how to heat up a game. Unfortunately, he overheated this time, so I had to retire him early. Couldn't have him spoiling the climax. Then you're the one who beat him? Why, yes. You're just as sharp as a tack, Neku. Anyway, the pest followed me everywhere. Even into the RG when I went to get you. Into the RG? Wait, no. Why don't I return all the memories I've been holding on to? He did fucking kill us? He was the one who killed us? Or did Minami accidentally kill us? Joshua running with a gun.
I blew it.
What?
Zawado. And Minami fled. Jesus Christ! Hell yeah. And he gave him a player pin. It was you! I thought I finally found a friend I could relate to. But it was you? You killed me? Now, Neku, why don't we play one last game? I'm done with your games! You tricked me. The winner gets to be the composer. And do whatever he likes with Shibuya. If you win, you decide. If I win, I'll decide. Of course, I've already decided. You're a monster. Neku, you better pick up that gun. I mean, this is going to be a duel. I'll keep the rules extremely basic. I'm gonna count down from 10. On 0, we shoot. See? Easy. Don't screw with me, Joshua. I assure you I'm not. Life's little crossroads are often as simple as the pull of a trigger. He says, after this motherfucker killed me. Neku, your face is priceless. Don't you remember what Mr. Hanakoma told you? I'm just... Oh, before I forget, I've collected your entry fee. It's fucking bait and shaky, isn't it? 10, 9... these weird fucking cylinder guns. Huh? Back at the scramble.
Why?
What the hell?
Seven days later, what the fuck is going on in any fucking capacity?
Same crowds too. Yeah. Shibuya hasn't changed a bit.
It's still here.
But still. I don't think I can forgive you yet. You don't see it, but those few weeks were very hard for me. Learning to trust people. Having that trust broken. Finding out the town I pegged is small and stifling and empty wasn't any of those things.
Let me in! Tell me what you're thinking!
Only by allowing strangers in can we find new ways to be ourselves.
I'm scared! Scared of getting a second chance!
Listen up, Bones! Because I ain't asking twice. Please, help me. You gotta help me save
Neku,
her.
That's the first time you used my name.
But Neku, I thought you couldn't afford to lose. Give up on yourself, and you give up on the world.
You ain't my partner anymore, man. You're my friend.
Once you see the real me, will we still be friends?
I'm glad I met you guys. You made me pick up on things I probably would have just gone on ignoring. Trust your partner. And I do. I can't forgive you, but I trust you. You took care of things, right? Otherwise, Shibuya would be gone, and my world with it. Hey, did I mention? I've got friends now. We're getting together for the first time in a week. See you there?
Yo!
Over here!
Is everyone back? Is everyone back? Yay! Rhyme's back as well! Yay! There may not be I still have no idea what the fuck happened at the end there! Hanakoma showed up! Joshua didn't shoot us! Was this all a test? Did Joshua just want to test a representative of his? For himself to personally determine whether Shibuya was worth keeping or not? Was that the idea? He picked someone and was just like, if this person can grow, if this person can prove themselves over the course of the week or multiple weeks, I'll save Shibuya, because if he's fine, then it means that Shibuya's fine. Is this a Q situation with Picard? Nah, this one dude's pretty chill though, so it means everyone's pretty chill though? Is that what's going on? I'm so confused. Do we get post-credit cutscenes explaining anything about the ending? I so desperately want to know what the fuck happened. I mean, we need at least one post-credit cutscene because we need to see what Shiki looks like. Because she wasn't there. He did, seemingly on purpose, pick the absolute most closed off and reclusive person he could to be his representative. Someone who was so closed off, it took literally 2 weeks in a row for him to open up, even though he had started learning that lesson already. Oh my god, it's gonna be Shiki, isn't it? Hey! Shiki! Actual Shiki and not Eri! Hey! I don't remember if we saw her before or not. I don't remember. I don't remember at all. Because that was her whole entry fee. Her entry fee was her own self-sense of identity. So she ended up looking like the person that she was jealous of. Then got here, then realized that she didn't want that. Dream No Distance is completely cavalier about Joshua being more than he seems. He straight up says at some point in that game, yeah, I'm kind of omnipotent. Man, it's a good thing I remember literally zero of the What Ends With You parts about Dream Drop Distance, isn't it? I remember literally nothing about what happened in there. It happened, it was in Traverse Town. And we saw Beat, Rhyme, Shiki, Neku, and Joshua. I remember nothing else. I remember nothing else. Hey, Pyro is now following. Welcome to the Arcosaurus squad. Although I've apparently fucked up the notifications on this layout because that didn't have a sound there for it. There's a different layout in the stream element, so I think I fucked up and didn't include the sound for it. I still want to know, like, I want anything post-game to explain. I just want to see Joshua talk a little bit more. I get his whole thing is meant to be weird and mysterious and everything like that because he's the composer. But like, Hanakoma... by Pyro. Like, Hanakoma showed up at the end. Why? Like, Hanakoma is Kat, yes. But why did he show up at the end? Why did he show up at the end? Because, like, everything that Joshua was saying to Neku... Well, in some capacity... Like, there was, like, Joshua was immediately, like, falling back into the way Neku was thinking, which immediately made Neku fall back into the way he was thinking. Like, there was a lot of parts where Joshua was just like, yeah, fuck people, people are suck, people are awful, fuck people. And, like, he was actively goading Neku into being his old self, actively, all the time. Whether that was him just, like, Joshua actually thinks that because he wants to destroy Shibuya because he finds it so boring, or anything like that, I don't know. But also, when Joshua showed up, did the conductor and no one else realize that was the composer? I mean, he didn't look like that when he was talking before, but still. Also, Joshua totally fucking led, by the way. He did not play from the sidelines in any fucking capacity. In no fucking capacity did he play from the sidelines. The world begins with you. The world begins with you. Hey. Hey, and the sequel's not called that. Hanakoma is also the person who told us, oh yeah, Josh and I go way back. He did say this, yes. He did say that, yeah. Hmm. So much thoughts. Ah, I still have so little idea of what actually happened at the end of the game there. And that's it! No extra further explanation, no, like, motive explanation or anything like that. Just, yeah, there you go. Hit continue real quick. I'll hit continue real quick. Look how quick I hit it. I haven't played for 22 seconds. Game cleared. Proves you've beaten the game. Now you can choose chapter select. There it is. You beat the game. This tale has now drawn to a close. If you like, you can revisit any part of the story. Just select chapter selection from menu. All your item spins and other stats will be carried over. You can fast forward through cutscenes. That would have been useful an hour ago. It would have been so useful to be able to fast forward through cutscenes an hour ago. Thank you very much. Delve into each chapter to unlock secret reports penned by, well, you'll have to see for yourself. Oh, fuck it. This really isn't a more Kingdom Hearts game, isn't it? Fuck. The report fleshes out the backstory for each day, and we hope answers some of your lingering questions. They know. The motherfuckers know. They fucking know that the ending, it does not answer everything, and you want to know more. They fucking know. Collect all the reports for one last surprise. We won't spoil it for you. Beating the game is also unlocked a side story, Another Day. Join the cast Alter Egos in a zany romp through an alternate Shibuya. Alright, it's all up to you now. Pick a chapter. Live a little. You can access chapter selection menu through your phone. That's the only way out of this room. Got it? Good. Tutorial box out. Oh, and we finally get... There is still one thing we haven't got. There's still one thing here we... That's probably just the secret reports. And the chapters are just fucking Joshua reading a book of the story. Oh my fucking god. Yeah, there's nothing else in this room. Okay, so we're not even close to done then? Is this what I'm understanding? I mean, Densha did mention before that there is post-game that I might want to do in this game. We're not close to done, are we? Like, we're not even fucking close, are we? It says go back to every day to get secret reports. We're not close, are we? There's still, like, a lot left, right? I'm thinking there's still a lot left. Like, significant amounts of content are still here for me to pick and claw my way at. So if I go to this... Okay. There's multiple stars on every day, and I have some and I don't have others? Okay. From this menu, you can replay any of the game's chapters anytime you want with items level select. Delve into each chapter and look secret report, which will lead you closer to the truth at the heart of this story. Fucking Kingdom Hearts shit. Oh my god. Alright, top screen, down the info, title and chapter summary are followed with a list of quests for the day. There is actually quests for every day. Shit. Which I've done very little of. Bottom screen, tap the panels. Touch a panel to play that chapter. The star corresponds to the quests on the top screen. Fill in the stars for each day and the question mark will change to a blue page. Oh, okay. Until the time is up, this game is never done. Until the time is up, which will be fucking never. Fill in the stars and we can do that and read a secret report. Okay. So we have to finish every side quest to get all the secret reports. Is that what I'm understanding? Keep all your powers! Yay, characters obtain their stats and abilities no matter which chapter you play. You pick a battle partner. Wow. Wow, you choose who you want to fight with for the whole game. Bonus chapter, Another Day. An absurdly original, or just absurd, side story based around Tin Pin Slammer. Oh, fuck. I have to learn how to actually be good at Tin Pin Slammer, I think. Fuck me. Where's best about report? Sometimes a report will ask you to find a report for a different day. Okay. Eliminate all the Pigno symbols. All of them? Okay. Get specified item. Hints will tell you where to look. Eliminate specified boss symbol. Select difficulty to hard and don't chain battles. If you beat the boss, your time will be listed in the noise report. What? What? This day ends with you. On a certain day, at a certain time, in a different world, this, like, totally really happened. Complete the following review. This is the report for B-Day 7. Chap down, eliminate all this chapter's Pigno symbols. Get the girl's uniform with sweater. This stage is as dark as ever. Eliminate the ultimate enemy at the top of Pork's... Another day's a ride? Okay, Densha, answer me honestly. Am I even halfway done this game? Am I even halfway done? Am I even close to half? There's story behind doing all the side quest shit. I want to get the side... I do the side quests and I get story. If you want to get the secret reports, there's a lot left. Fuck yeah. I mean, I very much enjoy this game. I very much enjoy this game, don't get me wrong. It's just, wow, there's a lot still to go. Okay. Denshi, you mentioned post-game content before. I didn't think there would be this fucking much. Chain of memories all over again. Oh, Jesus. Get the Miss Claus outfit. I said I want to go shopping. Eliminate the boss symbol and I'm A7 with the chapter at hard or above. I appreciate there's a lot of this that is actually play the game on hard. Death March lives again. Boys uniform with blazer. Collect the reports for other days. The blue text parentheses are hints on where the secret items are. Okay. Okay. Okay, so I can get a pirate hat, spicy tuna roll, secret reports author. I mean, so a lot of these secret reports, I'll get the one from the previous day. Like, in a single week, it is all get the report for the previous day is one of your things that you have to actually complete. So you do have to read them in order because you need the one from the previous day to even get a lot of them. Okay. Okay. If only they knew. Ah, the final chat just called game. Okay. Okay. Okay, so for the secret items to get, do you get those items on that day? Or is it just somewhere in the game get it and you need it for this day? It's on that day. Okay. Which, there's a lot there. There's a lot there. Okay, so we have a lot left to go still. We have significant amounts of content to do. Yes, I'm going to continue this LP to the point where I get all the secret reports. Yes, I will be doing that. The game has... I've got so many fucking questions. I have so many fucking questions about what to do and like what's going on with the game. I need these secret reports and I need them fucking now. Here's my big question, Densha, though. Should I start with the secret reports or should I start with another day? Or is another day meant to be like the thing I do last? Like the secret report for another day is get the secret report for Beat's final day kind of thing. So am I meant to do Pog? I mean, I was saying it's just like there might be one or two sessions of this this week for streaming. Depends on whether I beat the game on the first one, but nah, I beat the game. I'm just gonna continue this. I'm not gonna take this out of the schedule. I'm gonna continue doing this once or twice a week until we get all of that. Because if I slow down this game, I'll be playing this game for another game. As I start with another day, you won't be able to do the side stuff, but there's nothing wrong with jumping in to play through it casually. Okay, you will have to learn 10 pin for it though. Fucking fuck. Fuck. I don't wanna learn 10 pin. I don't want to learn Tenpin. Tenpin's dumb. I honest to God don't even know how Tenpin functions. I tried doing it before and flicking it and just none of the inputs seemed to do what I wanted it to do and I have no idea how it works. So yeah, it'll be a trial by fire. We're going to jump into it. It'll be a trial by fire. And we'll do that. But what I'm going to do now, I'm going to end it here because I'm definitely not doing another day now. Next time we'll start with another day, which is apparently a ride. We will start another day, and then after that, we will replay the entirety of the game again to get all the secret reports. But now we can skip cutscenes, or at least fast forward through them, so it's gonna be a lot easier. But we do also have to find all the secret reports shit, which is gonna be very hard. Because I imagine finding some of those things is gonna be awkward and weird. But I will end it here. Next time, another day. Another dollar and a lot of shit going on. So until then, this is version 2 signing out.
Best Wolf!
Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. Like, I just beat the game and it does not feel like the game's over. Like, even the conclusion to the story did not feel like I beat the game. Like, finishing the story of beating the game felt like I resolved the plot of now people are alive, like we've escaped the game, we've saved Shibuya. But it doesn't feel like the story finished. It feels like the story has a lot left to answer. Like, why did Joshua decide to keep Shibuya around after he won the game, which was meant to be about erasing Shibuya? He challenged Neku to another game of a duel and said whoever wins gets to choose what they do with Shibuya. Neku deliberately didn't do that, so I wonder if that was just like Joshua then going, I will decide to save Shibuya. Why did Hanakoma show up at the end? Joshua said that he was going to not interfere with the story, like, of the game that, Kitarija, or whatever his exact name is, was doing in terms of trying to save Shibuya. And then on week fucking two, he became our partner. Which does also make me wonder, like... He did remind Neku right before the duel, remember what Hanakoma said. Trust your partner. Yeah. He's definitely testing Neku's growth, yeah. That is what Neku said in the cutscene at the end there. I don't forgive you, but I trust you. That is what he said at the end there. But like, it does make me think it's literally Q. If you've seen Star Trek Next Gen, then you know what I'm talking about. Q is, spoilers for Star Trek The Next Generation. Q's whole deal in that is that he's omnipotent, he's basically God, he has godlike powers, and consistently throughout the series, he considers humanity not worth existing. They cause all these problems, they cause all these wars, fuck it, they're not worth existing. But he chooses one person, Picard, the captain of the Enterprise, and he's just like, you're the representative, and he's just like, if you can prove to me that humanity's worth existing, I won't erase humanity. And basically, it's meant to be Picard's, like, personality resolve, strength, values, beliefs, etc., 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 that make him decide that, okay, humanity's worth saving, I'll do that. I literally think this is the same as that, from what I'm gathering so far. Joshua said, okay, it's a game with Kitarija. Kitarija can do what he wants, but I'm going to choose the most closed off person possible. And if what they go through in the game can make them open up and change, every single person in Shibuya could do the same thing. If this person can, everyone can. And then it's worth saving Shibuya for. If this mega unfriendly person can change and grow, maybe the rest of Shibuya can. Literally exactly that, yeah. Like, that is my interpretation of what's going on so far. Which I think is both, like, it was too... encourage that and test that and push against that in week two for why Joshua became Neku's partner to try and both knock Neku back and encourage him to see where he'd go. Like, a lot of what Joshua says in week two to Neku makes Neku regress, but some things that Joshua says make Neku have that growth. And again, Neku grew so much in week two that he was helping Beat grow in week three. So, yeah, he proved the point. Like, Neku proved his point and stuff. Like, that's definitely what I'm picking up from here so far. But there's obviously still the parts that I'm not sure on, and I need to read all the secret reports. Also, keep in mind, there's a fucking sequel. Also, I've now purchased the Switch version physically, so I had to order it from overseas because apparently there was an extremely short print on World Ends With You Switch physically, which now bothers me even more that I bought the Switch version originally when I was going to do this LP, and then I returned it because I heard people say do the DS version instead. So I returned the Switch version, which now bothers me because now I've bought it again. To be fair, I bought it, like, I returned it and I got the full value back. Like, it was... I'd returned it like 3 days later. So I got the full value back for it. And then when I bought it online, it's basically the same price I originally bought it at. But it's more so, I have to wait for it to arrive from overseas. So in case you're wondering for the LP, I'm going to do the post-game stuff on this because I've already done this and I really like this version of the game. Like, I might have sounded annoyed at the end of the game. The only reason, the main reason I was annoyed is because unskippable cutscenes, which I still fucking hate, but now at least we can fast forward them. And especially how that resolves into the whole menu system. That was bad. The final boss fight I thought was garbage. It's fine. It's fine. I just totally missed the mechanic of the things at the top. Like, I looked at the top screen, I literally didn't even see the characters in there. Like, the pixels are small enough, I literally didn't even see them in the bubbles, so I thought I just didn't have to look at the top screen. But then looking at the top screen, oh yeah, no, they are actually totally there and I meant to get an attack boost from them. Oh, okay, I get it now. Like, I did not understand that to start with, so no, the final boss fight's fine. Again, I love this game. I fucking love this game. The story, characters, combat, all of that, like, all of my love for this game does come with the caveat of it's fucking weird, though, in a lot of ways, and I don't think all the weirdness lands. Like, the combat is really interesting, and I really enjoy the combat. The combat, like, when you get to the end boss fights, it really does feel like... Like, earlier on, it felt like you could approach combat how you wanted to, but it would stop you from doing certain things. But then it got to a point where I was just like, oh no, you can actually do it in different ways. Like, if you want to do a focus on your partner, focus on trying to get fusions with your partner, stun locking with your partner, all your different things. But the boss fights towards the end of it really felt like, no, do everything. Actually do everything perfectly. And I'm just like, I can't attack and dodge with Neku while also attacking and dodging and focusing on chains to get Carl to the top character. I can't do all of that at once, and it felt like the game was expecting me to. And I'm just like, surely the game understands that that's too much. All of the inputs on the pins, some of them like are good, some of them I don't. I might include this in the YouTube video, by the way. I did an outro for the YouTube video, but I'm still elaborating my thoughts, so I might include this in there. If you're watching this on YouTube, maybe I did. I don't know. I'll decide that in editing. Like, the pins, I like the pins, and I like how many different ways you can use them, all the different things you can do with them. Some of the inputs don't work super well, or are kind of awkward and kind of weird. You can level up pins, and that's cool, but, like, some pins you only level up by not playing the game, and then you get standby points. Other pins you only level up with the mingle system, but I can't do the mingle system now. And I imagine, like, even when this game came out, when it did, I imagine the mingle system in Australia would have been fucking garbage. And everything like that. The dual screen stuff, again, works well. It doesn't always land. Even just, like, the nature of the game on a day-by-day basis. Like, some days are action-packed, some days are more free, go wherever you want. Like, all the different stores you go to and buy stuff for, you buy a lot of stuff at a store and that store will level up, but you gotta put a lot of time and investment if you want those places to level up. Like, I'm glad the game does all of its weird stuff that it does. It makes the game super unique. There's nothing else like this. And a lot of it works very well. I just don't think it all lands perfectly. But to get rid of the stuff that doesn't land perfectly, the mindset would have had to have, don't make this game built around the DS. This game is the most DS fucking game that has ever existed. It, like, every aspect of the design of the game is about it being on a DS. Every single part of it is. And I'm glad that they did that because it's a completely unique experience. And I'm glad that I have a capture card for a 3DS that lets me record it in that true, like, even playing this on an emulator on a computer, using one of these would not be the same as actually doing it on this. Like, I love this game, honest to God. I don't know, the ending being a bit weak because it didn't explain some stuff does impact it, but also I know there's a lot more that I've got to do, so I don't know how much it impacts it. But, like, at this current point in time, it's not top 10, it's not top 20, but this might be, like, a solid top 30 games of all time. Like, this game I enjoy that much. I enjoy it that much that if, like, I don't know, like, I know what's in my top 10. I have a rough idea of what's in my top 20. From 21 to 30, I'm not really sure, but I feel like this could probably land in there. Like, just for how unique of an experience it is and how much of it I enjoy. I love the characters. I love the combat. I love the art style. I love the fucking music immensely. And the story's good. I don't know if I like the story as much as all the other parts. I feel like the game raised a lot of mysteries about what the fuck the nature of everything happening was. And then you get to the end of the game and none of that matters. Like, the nature of why does the game exist the way that it does? why is this meant to be about, like, Joshua has love for humanity and wants to do everything for all of that. But, like, none of that comes up. Or at least it hasn't yet. Maybe Secret Reports will. Narrative wasn't really strong enough to seriously affect lots of teens that played. Well, okay, here's my thing. Are we talking about... When we talk about, like, the narrative, there's so many aspects to it. The characters, I think, are by far the strongest part of it. So there's, like, the characters and their arcs and their growth and where they go with it. There's themes. Obviously, like, Kida Ryuji's whole thing at the end is fuck individuality, where the whole game's been going with a message of, like, your individuality is important. It's what makes you you. The individuality of everyone in Shibuya is what makes Shibuya Shibuya. The fact that it is all those different people. And it is meeting people who aren't like you that causes you to grow. So it's like, your individuality is super important, but it's super important because of how your individuality connects with other people, which is, by the way, my exact viewpoint on life. That's literally my view on life. Like, I see some people who are just, like, fiercely against individuality, because I understand that, like, because you get individuality of, like, the, for example, American sense. The individuality of America is, like, very much more in a situation of... Be your own person, be your own individual, fuck everyone else. But also, everyone else is also doing that. So if you don't conform enough, people will say fuck you. If you conform too much, people will say you don't have your own identity. And you having to be an individual means you have to put yourself ahead of anyone else and fuck everyone else, right? Like, so there's obviously individuality in certain things goes way too far. And, like, causes problems. And then, obviously, the exact opposite of individuality can go way too far in the other direction, where things are boring, no one grows, nothing's challenged. If there are problems, they're not questioned. Australia is that. That's Australia. Australia is very much... Everyone should be the same. Everyone should be like everyone else. And if anyone stands out in any slight capacity, burn that person. And also, because everyone is so alike, you can't question any of it. Like, that's Australia. The fact that this game's message is your individuality is important because your individuality is what connects you with other people is literally my exact view on life. So I really like that. Neku's words at the very start of the game, I've got my values, you can keep yours. Yeah, that's literally one of the very first things that he says. And, like, that's the whole phrase of the world ends with you, right? The world ends with you if you let your individuality shun you from, like, shun yourself out from the rest of the world. The world begins with you if you allow your individuality to be the defining feature that connects you to other people. But again, I get why teenagers vibe with the themes of this game as strongly as they do. It's literally my view outlook on life as well. Like, I try my best to be a fiercely individual person. I try my best to just be exact, like, who I am and who I feel like I am. I want to be that as true as possible, and I don't want to adjust that for anyone else. And obviously, you know, there's certain things that make that more true, and then, like, other different aspects. Like, I think most people who I come across do very much notice and very much mention and compliment or criticize that I am very much my own person. Like, I don't give a fuck what other people think in terms of if they don't like who I am, I care, kind of thing. Like, if someone doesn't like the type of person that I am, I don't really give a shit or anything like that, and I do everything I can to be fiercely individual, right? Like, a lot of people say that about me, and it's very much something that I pride myself on. But for me, that's all important because of other people. Like, being an individual to me would be pointless if it wasn't for other people. Because, like, it's something that I've always said about myself. Like, my individuality and, like, my purpose, my thoughts and everything like that, all of that only matters because of how it exists in relation to everything else around me. In of itself, it doesn't have any value. It has value because of how it connects with the greater, like, society, other people, culture, etc., etc., as a whole. And, like, I've openly said that for a long, long fucking time. So it is very good to see that the themes of this game are literally exactly that. And that makes me very happy. So, like, the themes of the game are strong, the characters of the game are strong. It's more so when you get to, like, plots and narrative that the game raises so many questions, or there's a lot of what's going on, that it feels like it raises because it wants to answer them, and then it doesn't. Like, why does the UD exist? Why is there a composer? Why is it when you die, you end up there? It feels like at the start of the game was going to answer all of that, or it would be important. And at the end of the game, it's more so just, that's how this world works, accept it. Like, there isn't a reason for it. That's just how it is. Which is totally fine, right? Like, you can have that, and that's totally fine. This is the world. Here it is. Like, you don't need to explain the reason of why the world is. It's just a different world. That's just how it is. But it felt like at the start of the game was caring about why, and towards the end of the game, it's more so about the how, in terms of, like, how this functions. What's the composer doing? Like, why, like, the composer wants to destroy Shibuya, doesn't destroy Shibuya, and everything like that. And then the narrative just ends on, you have a lot of questions, but, like, you won, your characters won, they get to do their own thing. I feel like we're just meant to take those as, this is just the way the world works. Yeah, I think it's important to point out that Joshua is specifically Shibuya's composer. He does mention about things spreading to other regions. That, like, it does seem like the game in this exists on the entire planet. And just every individual location on itself just has the game as a thing. Like, the afterlife in this universe is just this. This is just what it is. Like, there isn't any further, there isn't an explanation of why it happens. It's just how it is. Which, again, is totally fine from a world building standpoint. I don't think you have to explain, well, back in the day, this happened and it caused the UG to become a thing because of the... You don't have to do that, right? Like, you can just go, this is how the world functions. Here's the rules of how it functions. That's what it is. You want to know why it is? That's just how it is. Like, you don't have to know that stuff for it to be important. I just felt like at the beginning of the game, it felt like answering those questions was part of the importance. And then it just kind of faded into, that's just how things are as it went on. So I'm also, I have those questions because I feel like the game wanted me to ask those questions at the start and then just didn't. And then the answer at the end was, that's how it is. So there is also that. But anyway, I am kind of rambling at this point. I don't know if I'm going to include that in the YouTube video or not. I might. The point is, anyway, next time we're going to be doing another day. So just in case this is part of the YouTube video, because I expanded my thoughts a lot more than, like, that's normally what I do during the credits of a game, or expand my thoughts like that. So maybe I will, maybe I won't. I don't know. But the point is, until then, this is Version 2, signing out.
Yet unknown.